What is the Galactic Ghoul and why is it eating our space probes? Welcome to the domain of the Great Galactic Ghoul. Yes, forget Galactus and Unicron because this is no comic book fantasy. NASA itself recognizes the ravenous appetite of this void-tripping probe-gobbler. See, there's a great deal of trial and error when it comes to deep space exploration. And the 60s and 70s saw the US and the Soviet Union lose somewhere in the neighborhood of 24 different spacecraft. Even the simplest flight paths to Mars require months of travel. During the early days, radio communication was weak, and there were lengthy signal gaps. The losses even continued into the 90s with the 1992 disappearance of the Mars Observer Geoscience Climatology Orbiter. Naturally, the Ghoul has plenty of ancestors. Old maps warn of dragons in isolated waters. Royal Air Force pilots in World War II often attributed aircraft problems to mischievous gremlins. And you pretty much have your pick of 20th century Bermuda Triangle theories. But as with Mars, these cases all break down to the odds of technological or human failure in risky or high traffic environments.
Hey, if you enjoyed this video, be sure to check out these three videos as well.
And don't forget to visit us at stufftoblowyourmind.com.
Our planet does a pretty good job of protecting us from space, which is awfully nice of it because space is trying to kill us. Or at least maim us. Here are a few ways how.
The cosmos is teeming with singularities, wormholes, and inhospitable worlds, all strung out amid light years of void. In other words, you don't have to turn to science fiction to get your fill of space-related dangers. You don't even have to venture beyond the confines of the human mind.
There's no question. A NASA launch is an amazing testament to human ingenuity. But where did the space shuttle come from, and how does it work?